Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, et Spes Nostra Salve. Ad te clamamus, exules filii Eve, ad te suspiramus, gementes et flentes, in ac lacrimarum. Illos tuos misericordes oculos ad nos converte. Et Iesu, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome. Today, on this Thursday of the seventh week of Easter, we find that we are continuing our journey with St. Paul. Only now he's in front of the Sanhedrin. I want you to listen very closely to that first reading from Acts of the Apostles and think about how this interchange with the Sanhedrin occurs and what it means for us today. I'll talk about that in the homily. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. My dear friends, let us call to mind our sin, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us and forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Let us pray. May your Spirit, O Lord, we pray, imbue us powerfully with spiritual gifts, that he may give us a mind pleasing to you and graciously conform us to your will. Through our Lord, Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Wishing to determine the truth about why Paul was being accused by the Jews, the commander freed him and ordered the chief priests and the whole Sanhedrin to convene. Then he brought Paul down and made him stand before them. Paul was aware that some were Sadducees and some Pharisees, so he called out before the Sanhedrin, "My brothers, I am a Pharisee, the son of Pharisees. I am on trial for hope in the resurrection of the dead." When he said this, a dispute broke out between the Pharisees and Sadducees, and the group became divided. For the Sadducees say that there is no resurrection or angels or spirits, while the Pharisees acknowledge all three. A great uproar occurred, and some scribes belonging to the Pharisee party stood up and sharply argued, "We find nothing wrong with this man. Suppose a spirit or an angel has spoken to him." The dispute was so serious that the commander, afraid that Paul would be torn to pieces by them, ordered his troops to go down and rescue Paul from their midst and take him into the compound. The following night, the Lord stood by him and said, "Take courage, for just as you have borne witness to my cause in Jerusalem, so you must also bear witness in Rome." The word of the Lord. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. Keep me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, my Lord are you. O Lord, my allotted portion and my cup, you it is who hold fast my lot. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. I bless the Lord who counsels me. Even in the night, my heart exhorts him. I set the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. Therefore, my heart is glad and my soul rejoices. My body too abides in confidence, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your faithful one to undergo corruption. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. You will show me the path to life, fullness of joys in your presence, the delights at your right hand forever. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
Father, are in me and I in you, that the world may believe that you sent me, says the Lord. Alleluia. 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 The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Lifting up his eyes to heaven, Jesus prayed, saying, "I pray not only for these, but also for those who will believe in me through their word, so that they may all be one, as you, Father, are in me and I in you, that they also may be in us, that the world may believe that you sent me. And I have given them the glory you gave me, so that they may be one, as we are one. I in them and you in me, that they may be brought to perfection as one, that the world may know that you sent me, and that you love them, even as you loved me. Father, they are your gift to me. I wish that where I am, they also may be with me, that they may see my glory that you gave me because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world also does not know you, but I know you, and they know that you sent me. I made known to them your name, and I will make it known that the love with which you loved me may be in them, and I in them." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As So we're in chapters 22 and 23 of the Acts of the Apostles. We're only going to be in this for a couple more days and getting close to winding down the Easter season and this journey we've taken through Acts for these 50 days. But a couple important things we need to know. First, Paul's in front of the Sanhedrin. And by the way, bad things happen, it seems, when people are brought to the Sanhedrin. Jesus will be condemned by them. Peter and John, along with the other apostles, will be brought forward, and then afterwards they'll be whipped. And they'll still be praising God. But this notion of there's life and death here, something very serious is about to happen. Paul knows this. To be brought before the Sanhedrin, he's in good company with those who've gone before him. The second thing you'll notice at the end of this, when Paul gets this vision, this word of encouragement, that as you have borne witness to me in Jerusalem, so you will now in Rome. Now, we just got to think about this from a geographical point of view. Rome was the center of the empire at the time, the heart of the empire, source of power and might. Jerusalem's way out in the sticks. It's way out there in the backwaters of the empire. And what's going to happen here is Paul, who's been proclaiming, and Paul's a traveler. He's made multiple journeys into what we would call modern-day Turkey, Macedonia, and Greece. He's been preaching and teaching for years. So it's not like he doesn't know a lot of the outer rim territory of the eastern side of the empire. He's going to go to Rome. He's going to go to the heart of this thing to bear witness, to teach, to share the good news. This notion of bearing witness, not just on the fringe, but even at the very center itself, speaks loudly today. Because, folks, the fact of the matter is when you take these two things together, the Sanhedrin and bearing witness, it tells us that to stand up for our faith, we are going to encounter any kinds and sorts of opposition. It clues us in that to say, I follow Jesus Christ, is not a throwaway line. But just as it was true for St. Paul, it's true for us, that to bear witness to the Lord will mean that our faith, will be held up and scrutinized. Our words will be closely examined. Our actions will be watched. And people will wonder, do we say what we mean? Do we mean what we say? Paul had an opportunity to witness here. And as he gave his witness at the heart of the Sanhedrin, he inspires us to recognize that each and every day to say that I love Jesus and I want to live for the Lord means that we too will have to face that opposition. Not always, but let's face it. Being a Christian doesn't mean it's going to be sunshine and daisies day in and day out. It means that to live this faith, we're going to have to deal with any number of challenges, difficulties, trials, and struggles. But get this, Paul remained faithful. And his example can inspire us to do the same. His example to bear witness in all of these different places and spaces reminds us that in the highs and lows of life, when things are smooth sailing or when all hell breaks loose, we look to the Lord. We trust in the Lord. And we call upon the Lord for the help we need, the courage we need to face whatever comes before us this day. And so, what's on your plate? What have you got? Is it something personal, something physical? Is it something relational, something at work, something at home, something in life? That's what we take to prayer. Asking the Lord that, like St. Paul, we will be given the courage to bear witness, that we will be given the strength to hang in there, and that we will trust in the Lord to walk with us every step of the way, good times and bad, to give us the help we need, the direction we need through this life, to the life to come. God help us. God bless us all. We pray this day for the church, in a special way for those who will bear witness to the faith by being martyred this day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for peace. Whether we're talking globally in Ukraine, locally with those who are victims of senseless shootings, we Pray for peace between peoples, regardless of race, gender, creed. That we pray that the Prince of Peace will guide us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for those who go hungry, those trapped in a cycle of poverty, those who have struggled with addiction, abuse, or neglect. That through our efforts we can alleviate their suffering and help them break those cycles. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for all who are sick, for all who are awaiting medical procedures, surgeries, and tests. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for all those who are grieving the loss of loved ones. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intention of this Mass, Joanne Ranello. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For all of you at home, for the prayers you offer in the comment line, and for all of us, for the prayers we now offer in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious and loving God, look kindly upon us. Hear the prayers we offer now, spoken and silent. We make them all in the name of Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
O God, we earnestly ask you to bless our diocese with many priests, brothers, sisters, and deacons who will love you with their whole mind and heart and gladly spend their entire lives serving your church and making you known. Pray for our priests, religious, and deacons. Obtain for us a moment. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our loving Father. Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you. Through Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after his resurrection, he plainly appeared to all his disciples and was taken up to heaven in their sight, that he might make us sharers in his divinity. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, James our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress and useless worry, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
May the mysteries we have received, O Lord, we pray, enlighten us by the instruction they bring, and restore us through our participation in them, that we may merit the gifts of the Spirit. Through Christ our Lord. Some announcements. Please keep in your prayers, kids over at the school. Graduation for the kindergartners is tomorrow, and on Monday night we'll have Mass here for the eighth graders as they prepare to make their transition to high school. Please keep praying for Ukraine. Please keep praying for all who've been affected now at a global level by that. For those of you at home, please keep sharing on Facebook. If you're finding these at all helpful, your share is what allows it to get out there. It's interesting, the more I read about how this works, when things are shared, they keep getting moved out because that's the way the algorithm for Facebook works. When they're no longer shared or the sharing goes down, then Facebook limits who actually sees it. So keep sharing and we proclaim the gospel. Keep sharing and people who might not have seen a Mass before get a chance to see it on their screen. I appreciate all of you who do that. And if anybody wants a copy of the homily, you can always go to my website, studypraserve.com, or my podcast, Catholic Inspiration. Please stand.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
Have a great day.